Ah, finally! Halloween night has officially arrived, and everybody is going out in costumes, trick-or-treating, and demanding candy.
I bet my Patrick costume is going to win a lot of candy this year. No way. Everybody loves Donald Duck.
Not as much as Mickey Mouse, of course.
Shut up, baby lamb. You three don't know what you're talking about. Obviously, my Gordon Ramsay costume is going to be the best.
Come on, guys, it's Halloween! Who cares whose costume is the best?
Obviously everyone does, Belle. Because you never know when you may end up winning a Halloween costume contest that you didn't even enter.
Well, if that happens, that winner is gonna be me.
Ooh, maybe this guy's got candy.
Well, I hope so.
Trick or treat!
Hey, how you kids doing? Good, good.
Do you have any candy for us, mister?
Well, first off, my name is Matt Foley, and I am a motivational speaker.
Yeah, okay, we get it. You're a motivational speaker now. Can you please just give us the candy?
Now, before we get started, I want to give you a bit of a scenario so that way you understand what my life is all about. First off, I am 35 years old. I am thrice divorced. And I live in a van down by the river.
Okay.
Look, I'm sure your life is interesting and all, but can you please give us candy? That's all we're asking for.
Well, I don't have any candy, but, I do have some spooky Halloween story, if you guys are interested in it.
Okay?
Okay. Once there was a boy who liked to throw things. He started out throwing eggs, and he threw the big game. And he threw back a shot of whiskey. Then he threw up. Then he got thrown out of the house. And then he moved into a van down by the river.
What exactly is the point of this?
Look, it is my duty as a motivational speaker to let you kids know that as you go out there into the real world, you're going to find out that you're not going to amount to jack squat. Well, if you need me, I'm gonna go eat some expired candy in a van down by the river.
You know, it's a shame that people today won't get to enjoy this type of comedy anymore. Now, let's see. Bumblebee, Neil Patrick Harris, Quagmire, Popeye the Sailor, Prince Tuesday, and, Little Audrey. Oh my god, I loved that cartoon growing up. Yeah, that's right. I watch cartoons from the 1940s because I actually have good taste.
What the?
He didn't get any of our costumes right.
This is ridiculous. I paid good money for this Gordon Ramsay costume, and yet I get, dare I say, jack squat.
Well, that's what you get for choosing a salty Brit as your costume.
Hey. That guy's a genius.
Trick or treat!
But, do you kids know what time it is?
7:20?
Yes, and according to most grown-ups, like yours truly, that means Halloween is over and there ain't no more candy left. So go away!
Jesus.
Well, that was a bust. All that hard work and nothing to show for it.
Oh, well.
Maybe he just forgot to stock up on Halloween candy.
So, why did you want me to tag along with you and scan the neighborhood, Chief Mark?
Well, Derek, you're pretty much the only person taking this seriously. And you know that wearing costumes is just for little baby kids. Besides, I need your help so we can keep trick-or-treaters safe this Halloween.
Hey, kids.
Hey, Chief Mark. Hey, Derek.
Hi, B-Lam.
So, you kids being safe?
Yeah?
I make sure to wash my hands. Most of the time. Right. Anyways, I'm just making sure everything's going well and you kids aren't up to any mischief or whatever. You know, Halloween is the worst night of the year to be a cop, but you gotta do what you gotta do. So remember, if you egg or TP, you'll get arrested by me. See what I did there, Derek? I made a cool little rhyme.
Yeah, that's totally cool, Chief.
Yeah, I know. Well, happy Halloween.
So, now what?
I read in a book that when it gets too late on Halloween, adults just stay in their houses, look out their windows, and give you the evil eye.
Ugh, that's gonna be creepy. I love it.
Evil, you say? You think something evil's gonna happen on Halloween? Like, right now?
Oh, don't worry, Cal. I don't think anything bad's gonna happen.
Are you sure?
Trust me, everything's totally... who turned out the lights?
I don't know.
What's going on?
Why is everyone acting like zombies?
When are they gonna start dancing and singing like Michael Jackson? Guys, I think we're done for.
I didn't think it would have to end this way. I always pictured my death to be more majestic.
Well, it was nice knowing you guys.
My, my. Gathering around the campfire, I see.
The Dark Slayer?
What's going on, Slayer? Why did you make our friends act like zombies?
Oh, it wasn't just me that pulled this off. It was also the combined effort of some of my pals. And also, a lot of it was from the true spirit of Halloween.
Tom Turkey?
No, that's Thanksgiving, dumb butt.
I believe he was talking about me. Yes, scream. Scream as much as you want. That's what I feed off of. I am the true spirit of Halloween. I am Spirit Halloween.
Oh, so you mean?
Yes, the same Spirit Halloween that takes over those empty stores in the outlet during August. But that's besides the point. I was the one who had the power to zombify all of your friends. And right now, They're not your friends anymore. They're hungry. They're hungry for your praise.
Heh. Good luck trying to get something from Cal to eat. He ain't got any. Sorry, Ricky, what did you say?
Prepare yourselves. Prepare yourselves. Because this Halloween for you is going to be a living...
Not so fast!
What the... Okay, there is such a thing as too much lightning.
Who are you supposed to be?
I am the true spirit of Halloween. I am the Great Pumpkin.
Impossible. There is but only one true spirit of Halloween, and that is me. As you can see, I've managed to zombify everyone in town. What can you do?
Oh, I'll show you what I can do. Pumpkin powers, activate!
What just happened? Majax? What? You might want to take a look. What are you talking about? Holy crap! There he is! There he is! It's the Great Pumpkin, Bill Quackers! He has just risen out of the pumpkin patch!
What the? Why am I suddenly dressed like some stupid cartoon dad?
And why am I dressed like a dog?
Okay, everyone's de-zombified, but the villains are still undefeated.
And it's going to stay that way. Villains, attack!
Hey! Oh, I love the evilness.
Oh, and I hate goodness.
You fired.
I don't even work for you.
Wanna talk about politics?
Hey, put me down!
Oh, don't worry. I'll keep you in a nice, safe place. Well, I'm good.
Bo.
What are you gonna do to me?
Oh. Well, I'm not going to do anything to you. Say, Cal, want some candy?
Oh boy, do I!
But here's a twist.
I hate it.
Save the best for last. Oh, just imagine what I'm going to do to you.
Oh, no you don't.
Hey, what are you doing?
Pumpkin levitation.
I command you to get me down.
Oh, shut up. You're just a mascot for a chain of overrated costume stores.
So, Mr. Great Pumpkin, sir, how are you going to stop all the villains?
Yeah, how are you going to do that?
Oh, I'm glad you asked. Just a little something in my arsenal of mystical, magical pumpkin powers. A spell.
You wouldn't.
Oh, I would. In all that is hallowed, the Eve shall be saved. Go away, all you villains, or you shall face your grave.
What's happening?
Oh, I have no idea what's going on, but I don't like it.
What? Hey, this wasn't part of the deal.
I'll be back in 4 years.
No, this was supposed to be my Halloween. I was supposed to do the perfect trick. Oh, to all the girls I've loved before.
Wow. What about my friends?
Oh, don't worry, I'll take care of that.
Baby Lamb! You're okay!
Yeah. I'm surprised that I am. Did you see what Spirit Halloween was going to do to me?
Whoa, who knew a costume store mascot could be so evil?
At least you didn't have to spend a couple of minutes locked inside a water tower.
Why? Are you disappointed you didn't get to see Yakko, Wakko, and Dot?
Very funny, Ricky.